Hello and welcome to vlog number 2. My name is Andy and this is So Andy Sews. First of all, I wanted to say a huge thank you to everyone who has commented and subscribed and liked my first vlog. The response from you all has been absolutely overwhelming. I couldn't keep up with all your comments, but I hope I did. If I didn't, please let me know. It was incredible. Just the support and encouragement from you all has been absolutely amazing. And in the words of my dad, I was chuffed to bits. Now, I'm originally from Yorkshire. So Yorkshire via Southampton, then Dublin in Southern Ireland, Derbyshire, and ending up in Cornwall. So if I say some sayings or comments or phrases that you're not quite sure what they are, please let me know and I will try my best to explain them. But yeah, chuffed to bits. Thank you so much. I'm hoping with this one it might be a little bit smoother than the first one and there will be no or at fewer ums. I shouldn't really say it then. And the chair won't squeak. My mum commented on me. She said, Andy, you need to get that chair oiled. It squeaks a bit too much. So that'll be a job for the husband when he can do it. But hopefully this one will be a little bit smoother. And I am still very much in the learning phase of the editing part. So please bear with me. I will learn how to do it and look at the camera. But I'm very much learning that bit. So hopefully it will go a little bit smoother. In the last vlog, I mentioned that I've been making quite a lot of blouses recently. So I'd like to just talk you through some of the ones I've made. Now, one lady did say to me on the last vlog that I didn't mention what I was wearing. I did try to. I remembered the pattern company, but I couldn't remember the name of the pattern. And I had to edit that bit out because I think I would have probably been banned from YouTube if I'd have actually put that out. There were a few phrases in there that weren't really appropriate, but there we go. I'm a little bit more prepared today, so let's see how this goes. I'm going to put a little bit of a disclaimer in here before I start, but one of the things that's always helped me when I've been looking at new patterns, not just at the pattern envelope itself, but is to be able to see people actually have made the patterns and what they look like, and also their measurements. I found that really helpful and then sort of looked at them and thought, are my measurements any similar? Would that suit me? And hopefully that will give me some sort of guidance. And it's helped me to look at how that garment, sort of how that person's wearing that garment or how it looks on them. So I have taken some photographs. Modeling is not my forte, so I've done my best. I showed them to my daughter and my daughter's partner Ted, and they absolutely killed themselves laughing at them and thought it was absolutely hilarious, which some of them were quite amusing. And Ted sent me a picture of himself in one of my modelling poses, which I'm going to put in here. This is a little bit of payback for Ted. Tell me what you think. So the one from last week was the Sew Over It Juliet blouse. Now, I've made two of these. You'll have seen me in my first version when I'm on the actual front part of the YouTube bit. I'm going to change that up, but from last week you'll have seen me wearing that. It's over there, hang on a minute. So this was the first one. Okay, it's made in a spun viscose from the textile centre, which unfortunately are no longer supplying, which is a real shame because I used to get quite a lot of fabrics from them. And as you can see, it's quite a thin material, this. Have I? Yeah, it's got a burrito yoke at the back. I was just checking to see if I French themed it. You've got a really lovely floaty frill down the front here, which is double-sided, and then a little mandarin collar at the top here. That was, I think, was the only part that I had a few little sort of issues with, trying to get that sort of to fit neatly around the top here. But it's really lovely. I like it. It's very floaty. It's got a little box pleat at the back here. And then the sleeves are just finished off. Oh, they are actually, yes. Yeah. So they're finished off with the sleeve placket here, which I sometimes have trouble with getting that in correctly. And I found one of the best ways of doing that is to hand tack it in first, then go over it with my sewing machine. And it seems to sit a lot better when I do it that way. But yeah, I really love this blouse. The only thing I'd say now is it's quite low at the front here. I have lost a little bit of weight since I've made this one, and one of the first places I tend to lose it from is my bust. Ah, measurements. You need my measurements, don't you? Okay, right. So I am probably a box shape. So think of an hourglass figure, but without the middle bit. It's a box. My bust is about a 39 and a half. My waist, if I suck my stomach in, don't breathe, and measure myself, it's about 34. But in all honesty, it's probably more 35 and a half, or 36 if I've had a big meal. My hips are about a 39 and a half, so fairly sort of box shape. My chest is not in the same position as it used to be when I was several years younger. But as my dad would have said, a good bit of scaffolding will sort that out for you, dear. Has anyone ever heard the phrase, your dumplings are boiling over? It's something that my grandma used to say to us. You know when you've got a bra on that's not quite the right size, that's either a little bit too small or a bit too tight, and you get that sort of double boob thing going on? Yeah. But she used to say, Andrea, your dumplings are boiling over. Well, grandma, they're under boiling at this point in time. But anyway, that's number one, number one. Number two is on the lovely Mabel behind. This one was made in a Lady McElroy fabric. McElroy, McElroy, tomatoes, tomatoes. Let me grab it. Now, this one's still available. The fabric's still available from Sherwood's. I will put links down below to any of the fabrics if they're still available, so you can go and have a look at them. But it's a Marley Lawn, this one, and it's beautiful to wear. It's really soft, very floaty, and I love this one with a pair of jeans and brown boots that I had on last week. So they're the two from last week. Do we want this one, or should we go on to the others? We'll go on to the others and I'll come back to this one. Just a little bit more information on the Juliet blouse. The sizes, I believe, from Sew Over It are between a size 8 and a size 20, and the finished garment measurements for bust sizes are 36 and a quarter up to 48 and a quarter, and takes between 2 and 2.4 metres of fabric in a 140 width, and I think I got mine just out of 2 metres. I made a size 16. I think possibly for the next one I would go down a size, just to see how it fits. It is quite loose and floaty, but I like that. I don't like garments fitting too tightly. I like that sort of floatier look, but I think possibly to try a smaller size and just see how that sort of sits on me for the next one. And I have got another one cut out, so that'll be the third one, and it's in a beautiful fabric from Fabric Godmother, which is a green with sort of hearts on it, and I'll show you once I've finished it. Next one is the Josie blouse by Experimental Space that I made just a little while ago, actually. I am going to pop this on Mabel so I can give you a bit of a better look at it rather than showing you on the hanger. Bear with me one second. I think this is going to take some serious editing skills to try and make this look smooth, but here we go. So it's fairly simple front and back. So no darts, no pleats, there's anything in the front, and no yoke at all on the back either. I will put some pictures in of me wearing it, but the one thing that I really enjoy about this pattern is the detail that you've got on the sleeve. There you go, Mabel. So there's a pleat. My sewing's okay, it's my ironing's not brilliant, but there is a pleat here that then runs into the pleat on the sleeve and then just sort of falls down the bottom. And then there's a really sort of deep cuff on the end here. With three buttons on. And it's a really pretty blouse to wear. The fabric was from Walton's up near Rachel's. I don't think they've got any more left, and I do believe that there were some other suppliers online who were selling this, but I haven't been able to find it. It's a really lovely fabric, so sorry about that one. But yeah, this is the Josie by Experimental Space. Now their sizing, size ranging on this one is between 6 to 30. It takes about 2 meters of fabric, and it suggests either a viscose or a rayon, some sort of lightweight drapey fabric. So not quilted cotton. And it's a really lovely make. I enjoyed this one again with jeans and boots. Can you see a bit of a theme going on here? And I'll pop some pictures in, hopefully at this point in time, of me wearing the Josie. So the next one is the Patina Blouse by the Friday Pattern Company. This one's a fairly recent make, actually. If I'm being honest, I'm not quite as keen on this one. I don't know if it's the fabric. I think the style is okay, but I'm not quite sure if the fabric suits me. I tend to quite like colourful ones, as you can probably see, and this is a little bit on the darker side. So let me bring her in. The fabric's beautiful. The fabric's an Atelier Brunette fabric that I got from Stitches and Cream in Falmouth. Sewed up like an absolute dream. It's got a lovely drape to it, but I just don't think the colours are me. I'll show you the pictures and then let me know what you think. But the only problems I had, I think, when I made this one, the colour went in quite well. Show you. Not so sure about the buttons, actually. I don't know if I'd change the buttons. These are sort of a wooden button. I just picked them because they tended to go with the brown in the fabric itself. The only problem I had with this one, and again, it's the old placket on the cuff here. I've done quite a few of these, but for some reason, this one seemed to stump me a little bit. And again, I did the hand stitching in, so I laid it out, tacked it in, then sewed it, and then it seemed to work like a dream. I can't seem to get my head around it when you actually pin it in and then try and sew. My pins get in the way, so I find the hand tacking in and then stitching over then removing the tacking stitches seems to work a lot better with this one. So you've probably seen this loads of times on other people, but yeah, this is the Patina. I think it's a bit of a Marmite one, this one. Some people like it and some don't. I think it's this sort of statement bit at the front here, but yoke at the back. And then your collar goes all the way around here. And then some pleating in the back here and pleating over the shoulders there. It's quite a good size range in this one. So it goes from a, let me look at my notes, an XS to a 7X. So it's a 32 to 33 chest up to a 59 or 60. Finished garment measurement sizes are between 39 and 66, and it takes, fabric wise, it takes between 1.9 and 2.5 meters of fabric, depending on the width of your fabric. Now, if you want me to go through any more of the construction with each of these particular blouses, let me know and I will do, but I'm sort of whipping them through quickly just so you can see what they look like and the pictures of me sort of wearing them and what you think to each particular one. Next one I've got is the Sew Over It Anderson blouse. This one is a little bit of a fail. Not anything to do with the pattern or the fabric, more down to me. This one. I'm not sure you can see it very clearly because it's Mabel, it's red and Mabel's red. But I will again put some pictures on. So the fabric is from the lovely Rachel. So the fabric's a beautiful viscose fabric and I really like the colour. The problem with this one is it's too big. It's very flappy here. And it can be a little bit indecent if you're not tucked in properly. I think it might help if I possibly put some more stitching at the bottom down here to hold it tight, but I just feel like I might sort of lose something while I'm wearing it. So it's still got the pins. It needs the hand stitching finishing off at the bottom here. And I think that because I don't feel as comfortable wearing this, It sort of sat on the pile and hasn't been finished in the naughty corner. So again, sew over it is 8 to 20 size wise. It is very generous in size, this one. It's 33 to 45, they say, with a finished garment measurement of 38 to 50. So you've got some lovely pleating up at the top here. And then around at the back, it's just a plain back, and it's quite a lot of binding around the neck here. The sides themselves are just overlocked here, but I'll pop some pictures in again. And most of the pictures of me, I've got them tucked into my jeans again. I don't, the actual style itself I like, because I quite like this sort of floaty look, but yeah, this bit's not sort of doing it for me. Meterage wise, it takes between 1.7 and 2.2, again depending on the width of your fabric, but this is not one of my favorites. I will try it again in a smaller size and maybe see if I can do something with the bit here, the crossover bit. Now I did put some ties on the bottom of this one to try and sort of cinch it in a little bit more, but that still doesn't seem to have worked. And like I say, I'm a bit conscious that I might be inappropriately flashing at some point in time when I'm wearing this one, so this one doesn't tend to get worn. Gosh, I'm racing through these, aren't I? So the final two is the one I'm wearing and the one behind, which are similar in that they've got the pin tucks across the front. You've probably recognised the patterns. This is the Tilly and the Buttons, and this is the new Atelier Jupe. I'll get it right one day. This is the Emma blouse. So let me bring Mabel over and show you the difference between the two. So there's a lot more, depending on how you choose to do it, because there's quite a different, there's quite a few options with this particular blouse, depending on whether you want to put the pin tucks in the top, which I did, and also in the sleeve here. This is the first time I've done this sort of pin tuck thing. I quite enjoyed it, actually. I found that when I was doing the top part here, I'd sew them all in the one direction first, all the ones that wanted to go up, and then I'd sew the ones that wanted to go down afterwards, and that seemed to work quite a bit better for me. It's again, it's in the spun viscose, similar to the Juliet blouse, the same fabric. I decided to do quite a long or a deep hem on this one, so it's quite a bit shorter, I think, and it's got some lovely sleeves with some elastic in the bottom here, so quite a sort of a blouse effect on the end of the sleeves here. Pig to iron, absolute pig to iron. Not one that I'll give my husband, but there we go. So yeah, but it's a pretty blouse. Of the two, so this is the Emma blouse that I'm wearing here, I prefer this one. They've both got a very similar neckline, so they've both got the lovely ruffle effect, and I think Andrea from Beyond the Pink Door mentioned that it's not tight at the neckline, and it's definitely not tight at the neckline. It feels very comfortable. I love the sleeves. I also love the fact that there's nothing you have to do with the cuffs. You just create the cuff. There's no openings, there's no buttons to attach, there's no plackets. It's great, and it's a really good length on me. I'll pop some pictures in. Andrea's just done a tutorial for this on her YouTube channel, which I will link below. And I must admit, she timed it absolutely perfectly. So I just cut this one out. I just started to do the pin tucks along the top, and then Andrea put her vlog up, which was amazing, because then it meant that I could be completely lazy, not look at the pattern, and just watch Andrea. And I finished this one last night. There is a little bit of hand sewing, but I guess that's down to you and your personal choice. But I hand stitched the neckline in, I hand stitched the cuffs in. As Andrea says, it's quite difficult to get that part under the sewing machine. She's very right. So there was a little bit of hand stitching there, a little bit of hand stitching at the back. And it's actually one of my favourites, this one. It's in an Atelier, no it's not, it's in a Lady McElroy fabric from Sherwood Fabrics, a fairly recent one, and I will pop the link for it if I can find it, which should be okay. I'll pop the link for it down below. I do plan to make this one again in this fabric here, which I got from the very lovely Andrea at Beyond the Pink Door. This is an Atelier Jupe fabric. I'm going to write that down. It's beautiful colours, absolutely beautiful fabric. What do you think? I'm totally going to copy the pattern envelope or the pattern. It's been made up, the Emma Blouse has been made up in this fabric, and I think it looks absolutely stunning. So yeah, if I get this finished by next week, I will show you. But I think I've got a little bit of mending to do for my daughter who's going on holiday, and she wants me to make her another couple of pairs of these saguaro pants. I've made her about 4 pairs already, I think. She really likes them, so she wants another couple to take on holiday with her, and a couple of hemming jobs and mending jobs, so that's taking a bit of a priority at the moment. But hopefully once, it shouldn't take me too long, but hopefully once they're done, then I can make a start on this one. And just finally, before I sign off, I just wanted to say again a huge thank you for all your support. The very lovely Lorianne has asked me if I would do a tour of my sewing room. Very happy to. It probably won't be very long, but I'm really happy to. And Sue left in a comment that she wanted me to pop some pictures in of Cornwall, which really happy to do that too. So I will pop them at the end of this. If anyone else has got any requests or wants to know anything, leave me a comment, let me know. But again, a huge thanks. Thank you for your support and your encouragement. And I will see you again very soon. Bye-bye.